The Samaritan is the maid. He doesn't care very much. He's just offering his help. Have you ever had people in the, you know, maybe not a highway, probably it's too difficult if it's a highway, but along the road and you see someone just, you know, the car broke down, and the other person is like waving and says, come on, just stop, help me. Very often we'll just zoom by. But I tell you, when you yourself ever had your car broken down by the side of the road, and you wave and wave and someone stopped for you, the next time you see someone else like that, you are going to stop for him. How many of you know what I'm talking about? Because you have experienced that helplessness, that hopelessness, you have experienced it. That's why you know how to feel. Jesus says, do not rejoice that you have authority to trample on scorpions and serpents. But rather rejoice that you are a person that is like God. You are a son, a child of God. You are like Him. What's the point? You are a king and a prophet that has all wisdom, but you have no love. You're not like Jesus. You're not like God. So verse 37. Jesus then said, okay, verse 36, right? Let me just read one more time. So which of these three do you think was neighbor to him who fell among the thieves? Verse 37. And the lawyer answered, he who showed mercy on him. Then Jesus said to him, go and do likewise. Now, in this story of the Samaritan, the priest, and the Levite, Jesus would be the, talk to me, Jesus in these three characters will be the Samaritan, correct? So, because he didn't need to come down to the earth to serve us, he didn't need to come to die on the cross, to risk his life for us, he didn't need to, but he saw us destitute, helpless, hopeless, bitten, half dead, robbed. He stopped by as the Samaritan to reach out to us. Okay. So then, from the perspective of the lawyer, Jesus is saying, the Levite followed after the priest. So now, lawyer, follow after the Samaritan. Likewise, go and do likewise. Two paths, two roads, two comparisons. You find this kind of train of thinking and thought go running throughout. Make a choice. Do you want to be like the Samaritan and like be like Jesus? Or you want to be a wise and prudent person like the priest and the Levite? Many desire to see the things you see and do not see. Many desire to hear the things you hear and do not hear. So this first story is about seeing. The second story right now, as we bring this message to a close, is about hearing. Verse 38. Now it happened as they went, that he entered a certain village, and a certain woman named Martha welcomed him into her house. And she had a sister called Mary, who also sat at Jesus' feet and, read out loud for me, heard his word. Hearing. See that? Seeing and hearing. But Martha was distracted with much serving, and she approached him and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Therefore, tell her to help me. And Jesus answered and said to her, Martha, Martha, you are worried and troubled about many things. But one thing is needed, and Mary has chosen that good part which will not be taken away from her. Question to you. Mary and Martha, who is wise and prudent, and who is a maid? Who is wise and prudent? Martha. Trouble about many things. But Mary, maybe it doesn't sound too right, but Mary is a maid. She's the one that sit down and want a relationship. Sit and hear and listen to the word of God. Do you see how the word of God shows you comparison again? Martha, Mary. priest, the Levite, the Samaritan, Jesus. It's all to show us, choose. Choose wisely. Mary has chosen wisely. That good part which will not be taken away from you. Do not rejoice that you have authority over scorpions, but rejoice in that good part which will not be taken away from you, and that is that your name is written in heaven. Don't run away from God's presence. Run to God's presence. Choose God. Above all the career advancement, promotion. Not that all these things are wrong, but don't have your career advancement at the expense of you having a relationship with God. There's so many people who take on a job that cause them to go overseas. No church, separated from their family, just so that they can earn another $2,000 more every month. That's not being wise. Some people choose a job, get a promotion, become a station manager of a retail outlet, but you cannot come to church on the weekend. Because you have to work, retail outlets. You choose. So what? You have more money. So what? You have more authority. You have no relationship. Brothers and sisters, there's a way the world works. But that's not the way God wants us to. Choose. Do not be troubled about many things. Choose to hear God's word. Choose to follow the life of Jesus Christ. Look out for needs. Look out for the needs of people around you. Don't ask, but this person is not from my church. Or that person, you know, he is not from Kuala Lumpur. So what if I reach out to him? He lives in JB. He's going to go back to JB. Don't be like that. Be a babe. Don't be so wise in that sense, quote unquote, wise and prudent. Be a babe that is like Jesus Christ. Do you know that the Lord's Prayer says this? Give us this day our daily bread. Remember the story of the Syrophoenician woman that came? The mother asked Jesus, saying, heal my daughter, she's demon possessed. And Jesus says, it's not good for me to give the children's bread to dogs. She says, even the dogs eat the crumbs under the table. Bread symbolizes healing. When this friend came at midnight and asked this other friend, he's not even asking for himself. He's really asking for that friend that's come on a long journey. Every time you see a need, you see someone in need, you ask God to heal you. You ask God to provide for you. You are just like that man who is shameless. You are without shame. You are a child of God. You come before God and you knock. And it shall be open to you. When you see CKL, your church is like this, always looking out for a need, always looking out for a hurt to heal. Not no strings attached, not because you want something out of this, but just because you want to be like Jesus, the Son of God. Let's give the Lord a big hand. Hallelujah. Let's just close our eyes and bow our heads and let's just pray. Lord Jesus, we want to be like you. Lord, there's only one life, one kind of life that we want to be. We want to follow. We want to mirror our lives with. That is your life. Selfless. A life that is sacrificial. A life like the Samaritan. It's not always calculative. But it's a life that's willing to give at the expense of self. Lord Jesus, I pray for CBC here. Let us all be, in your eyes, a babe in Christ. Like the disciples, with eyes to see and ears to hear. So that we can walk in the same path that you walk. So that we can always walk so close with you in humility as a child of God. Thank you, God, for giving this day to us our daily bread. If you are sick in the body here in this place, as I just pray, I want you to reach out to God and ask God to touch you and heal you. Because tonight here in this place, if you have a financial need, God can provide. If you have a need in your family, God wants to meet that need. Just understand, you are a child of God. And you're coming before Him today in this relationship. So Father, I pray for everyone who's sick in the body, that in the name of Jesus, you will heal them of this sickness. Lord, every pain, every illness will leave them, leave their body in Jesus' name. Let the resurrection power of Jesus Christ, through the power of the Holy Spirit, be in their body right now. Father, I pray for those who are going through financial difficulty. Lord, they're experiencing their life under the weight of debt. I pray right now that a miracle will come upon them as they continue to be faithful to you. Lord, in serving you in this house, in giving to you of your substance, that you will bless them, you will honor their faith, you will open the windows of heaven and pour a blessing so great in the storehouse will not have enough room to contain. I pray for those who are going through a crisis in relationship, could be marriage or in any other area. I pray for reconciliation in the relationship. I pray that you forgive us our sin, as we forgive those who sin against us. Father, we thank you, O God, that you always lead us not into temptation, but you deliver us from the evil one. Yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. And everyone say, Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand. Praise the Lord. I have we just take about a 5 minutes break, and then you can go to the washroom and one more message to share from the book of Matthew. God bless you.